When I was young and in my prime, kind fortune on me smiled. My parents reared me tenderly, I being their only child. But it seems fortune has a way of turning on its heel. My parents stepped out of this world, and by their graves I'd kneel. At 12 I came to London town, I lived on bread and an ale. Then someone stole an apple from a costermonger's pail. I was stopped by a young constable, hard by the coster stall. I said the name I answered to was that of Ellen Hall. I said the name I answered to was that of Ellen Hall. Though I had no sense of a plot or how it might unfold, I came under great scrutiny from men both young and old. And when I looked into their eyes, I saw into their souls. Some drink from Pyrian springs, most drink from filthy bowls. Constable Chris had warned of those men and their wiles. You must proceed with caution through St. John's Wood and St. Giles. I would hide a knife from the kitchen under my ragged shawl. I was less fearful for my life than that of Ellen Hall. I was less fearful for my life than that of Ellen Hall. So many men made an attempt, so many would be foiled. One from the household cavalry with whom I'd be embroiled. The tales men tell to most young girls are mostly cock and bull. But his jacket spoke true as blood, it was dyed in the wool. And I would find no little joy in his cavalry twill. It saw me through the winter I spent on Ludgate Hill. For when a cavalryman wanders through the Strand and Pall Mall, the face he's seeking in the dark is that of Ellen Hall. The face he's seeking in the dark is that of Ellen Hall. This was a world in which a threat was hardly ever veiled, but the eternal verities eternally curtailed. William had seemed a decent sort, I was under his spell, yet he'd been courting Miss Jane Locke, lately of Tunbridge Wells. The agitation in my brain was more than I could quell. I knew he'd come from Hastings, he'd ridden from there pell-mell. For some reason he kept insisting he was still in my thrall. He yearned for no one else's heart but that of Ellen Hall. He yearned for no one else's heart but that of Ellen Hall. He'd follow me to Drury Lane, though my ardour had cooled. Now he had the temerity to say that he'd been fooled. But it was William played me false, he who was full of guile. Some say they heard a terrible crack when his head hit a tile. Some say they saw him coming close to give me an earful. Some say they saw grey matter a-seeping from a skull. They say they heard him mutter as on the tiles he'd scrawl. The name he would write out in blood was that of Ellen Hall. The name he would write out in blood was that of Ellen Hall. The thing on which I still remark is my name being misspelt. I still hear his sad entreaty, it still makes my heart melt. as I have melted in the past when I heard him wail. He'd been accosted by two rogues in swanky maid of veil. Now I am rooted to the spot, a Bow Street prison cell, where I'm halfway through Dryden's poem on a kit of fell. Tonight I feel ever more threatened, my back is to the wall, and I must prove I have such pluck as had that Ellen Hall. And I must prove I had such pluck as had that Ellen Hall. To think that those once most revered are now the most reviled. The dock I'll take quite modestly, though I may be with child. For cavalry men have a way of turning on their heel. Sometimes they press themselves on you and come up against steel. As every magistrate well knows, a woman can't seem frail. As every magistrate well knows, a woman can't turn tail. That's why I stayed in Drury Lane, stayed in the Prince of Wales. It was too late for Dover, much too late to board the mail. Now I pray my Sergeant Christopher will catch me if I fall. I pray I'll meet a kinder fate than that of Ellen Hall. I pray I'll meet a kinder fate than that of Ellen Hall.